The intelligence and cognition of elephants is on par with those of apes and whales, sharing many aspects of social culture and communication skills. Strikingly, the last common ancestor of these three evolutionary distant groups was a small primitive mammal that lived some 160 million years ago. Cognition thus evolved in elephants, apes and whales independently by convergent evolution. Convergent evolution is a phenomenon by which similar organs or traits evolve independently, like the wings of birds, bats and insects. This can teach us a lot about how evolution works and on the constraints and benefits that cause these traits to evolve time and again. This is particularly fascinating when discussing cognition and communication that are among the most advanced traits that evolved on planet Earth. It is tempting to speculate that a major factor that led to this evolution is its role in sexual reproduction and parental care. It is late afternoon here in Hwange National Park in Zimbabwe, and we just arrived at the Big Tom Observation Tower. Out of a cloud of dust, a huge herd of thirsty elephants is dashing towards the waterhole to quench their thirst. This primordial view is one of the most uplifting experiences one can have. Hwange is a huge and wild place with very few tourists, and I'm tempted to keep this secret to myself, but this would be unfair. Zimbabwe is a very poor country, and conservation here desperately needs funds. Even this water the elephants drink depends on pumps installed by charities. Rangers in ragged uniforms and old rifles patrol the bush on foot, protecting wildlife against poachers. Once we picked one up, and he told us that he waited for 3 days for a lift. Not far from here, Sharon Pincott lived for 13 years in a simple hut studying elephants. In her touching book, Elephant Dawn, she describes the intimate relationships she developed with many of the females and what she learned from them. Most of what we know today about elephants is thanks to the ongoing research Cynthia Moss started almost 50 years ago in Amboseli National Park in Kenya. Her books were of great help for preparing this video and are a most valuable source for further reading. Elephants live in a multi-level fission-fusion social structure. Females and adult males live in separate groups. Most research was done on female groups, and we know relatively little about males. The basic family unit comprises of related adult females like sisters, daughters, and nieces, as well as their juvenile offspring. This unit is led by a matriarch. Such a family can have between 2 to 10s of members. Females usually remain in the families in which they were born for life. Males, however, must leave once they grow and reach their teens. The social capacities and the legendary memory of elephants enables them to know and remember hundreds of other individuals. This leads to complex relationships with members of other families with whom they meet from time to time. Judging from the large number we see here, I assume that we see several nuclear families, but from their relaxed interaction, they all seem to know each other well. Talking about convergent evolution, sperm whales have a very similar social structure of females that live together with juveniles and pods, and males that lead a solitary life.
The gestation of an elephant is, with 22 months, the longest of all mammals. After birth, the baby remains dependent on his mother for many years. Most of his nutrition in the first 2 years is by lactation, and he stops to suckle on when he is 3 years old. Maternal investment in feeding is that much higher than during pregnancy. Here we see how mother ushers her baby to cross a muddy puddle pointing with her trunk. Strikingly, up to the age of 8, elephants spend 80% of their time within a few meters from their mom. Other females, grandmothers, aunts, and older sisters, also help with parenting, and even led the babies to suckle to comfort them.
Physical contact is of utmost importance for these gentle giants and is comparable to the continuous grooming we see in monkeys. From this permanent contact, you can imagine how traumatic a forced separation from the mother can be. Tragically, such separation happens only too often due to poaching and abduction of young elephants for sale to zoos. Elephants give birth for the first time when they are 15 years old, and they will have a baby every 4 or 5 years for their entire life. Elephants can reach an age of 60 or 70 years. Their life expectancy is determined by their teeth. They have 6 sets of teeth that are replaced on average every decade. After the last set is worn down, the elephant can no longer eat efficiently and dies. Young males leave their family gradually between the age of 9 and 18, presumably to prevent inbreeding. This too is reminiscent of the pattern observed in many monkeys. Young males often join a group of males led by an experienced adult bull. A striking example of the role of these groups can be found in the following story. Poaching and culling left the South African reserves devoid of mature males. The young elephant males in these reserves demonstrated an atypical aggression towards rhinos and killed many of them. This was surprising, as elephants, as you can see here in Etosha National Park in Namibia, rarely attacked rhinos. When adult bulls were reintroduced into the reserves, the rhino killing stopped overnight. The adult bulls keep the young ones in check and teach them manners. This is only one example of many that demonstrates how elephants can convey complex social messages. Males start to produce sperm in their teens, but their size is much too small and their status too low to compete with mature males and mate. Consequently, most babies are sired by a very small number of the most dominant bulls. Elephant mating is a complex procedure. To guarantee fertilization, females therefore prefer mature, experienced bulls that have a large penis, like the one you can see here. Younger males are both inexperienced and have a much shorter penis. The mature bulls allow, however, the young ones to watch and learn. Elephant bulls periodically enter must caused by a skyrocketing rise in testosterone levels. Elephants in must can be identified by secretion from the temporal glands behind their eyes, by the black urine dripping on their legs we see here, and by their highly aggressive behavior. These bulls are sexually active and emit sounds that attract females in estrus. In mature bulls, the annual must lasts 3 to 4 months. The presence of these mature bulls apparently suppresses the must of young males, decreasing it to a few days a year. Cognition, outstanding memory, and communication abilities are vital for living in harsh environments. Try to imagine in what climate we could survive without such skills. We are in the desert in Namibia, one of the driest places in the world. It is astonishing to find here elephants that need vast amounts of plants and water. The fact that elephants thrive here is testimony to the exceptional experience and knowledge of the matriarch that knows how to find food and water even in drought years.
The traditional seasonal long-distance migration routes of elephants are now restricted by reserve and international borders. We are here in Chobe National Park in Botswana. A complete hunting ban made this into one of the most animal-friendly countries in Africa, creating a safe haven for elephants. Sadly, this ban was lately abolished so that even here animals are no longer safe. One of the reasons for removing the ban were conflicts between farmers and elephants that eat their crops. There are, however, creative, less deadly, alternative ways to reduce friction between elephants and farmers. Chobe is on the border with Namibia, which we see here across the water, and with Zimbabwe, we just visited.
I'm standing here on a baobab tree, which is in the Chobe National Park in Botswana. Baobab trees are huge. They are one of the iconic symbols of Africa, together with elephants. What you can see here is what an elephant was peeling off the bark of this tree because it likes to chew it and to get moisture and to get sugar from it. And unlike many other trees, this tree is completely immune. You can see it has many scars, but it is fine. Nothing happened to it so far. And it continues to grow.
Elephants are a key ecological species. They are neither predator and they rarely fall prey. Yet, their ecological importance is crucial for the entire food chain. Elephants break trees, in particular mopane trees, and thus prevent them from taking over the savanna. Most large herbivores feed on grass, which is the base of the entire food chain. The mopanis that the elephants here in Chobe gobble are pretty inedible to most other herbivores. It might be heartbreaking to see a tree that took years to grow coming down in seconds. We, however, must realize that it is important for the entire ecosystem. By restraining trees, elephants thus enable grass and all who depend on it to grow and prosper.
I'm holding here in my hand elephant poop. Elephants eat a lot. They eat hundreds of kilos of plant matter every day, and their digestion system is not very efficient. So about 50% of the energy comes out again, and this can serve many other animals which will eat it. You can see all the time birds picking in it and other animals eating from it. Seeds of lots of plants have to pass through the digestive system of the elephant, and only then they can germinate.
Elephants like to drink clean water. When necessary, they dig holes so that the water can filter through the sand and seep into them. While on a walking safari, we too use such holes to collect drinking water. They love to bathe and are excellent swimmers. They can also dive and use their built-in snorkel. They also love to play in mud, and sometimes, as you can see here, this can lead to trouble. We watched this drama in Kidepo National Park in northern Uganda. Unfortunately, we were a bit far, compromising the quality of the video. A young elephant got stuck in the mud and his mother tried in vain to rescue him. She called the entire family and luckily they managed after a lot of time and team effort to salvage him from the sticky mud. After a mud bath, elephants like to scratch on trees. These two males blocked our way for ages while scratching. Dusting is another part of the daily routine. By the way, this is the elephant from the logo of the course. The elephant's trunk is highly versatile. It serves for drinking, spraying, lifting, stroking, peeling, smelling, communicating, trumpeting and fighting. It is immensely strong, but can be used for very gentle and meticulous manipulations. The ears of the elephant are also unique. They serve, among others, for cooling and to express emotions. The sense of smell of elephants is several times as acute as that of dogs. Here, we see an elephant erecting his trunk to smell. Eyesight of elephants is rather weak. However, they have a tremendously rich body language repertoire. Their sense of hearing is very sharp, and their vocal vocabulary is very impressive and rich. The frequency of some of their voices that serve for long-range communication is below human perception. Elephants are very special souls and can walk so silently that one can often hardly hear them. A nocturnal adventure we had demonstrates how noiseless they can move. We stopped to camp in Botswana one evening and saw someone fixing a tap by our campsite. In the middle of the night we heard all of a sudden a sound of gushing water. We peeped out of our rooftop tent only to find ourselves eye to eye with a huge elephant. He pulled the tap out of the ground and happily slurped the tasty water. Apparently he did this every night while the warden of the camp fixed it the next day. We crawled terrified back into the tent hoping that he won't notice us. The elephant was so quiet that we didn't hear at all when he walked away. Elephants are the only animals that might attack and damage vehicles and their passengers, and it is important to respect them and take care when driving close to them. There are rules how close one should get, depending on how used the elephants are to humans. Here, we see irresponsible behavior that both harass the elephants and endanger the travelers. Hunting, even so-called regulated one, of such highly evolved beings can only be called murder. Hunting for ivory reduced the African elephant population by more than 90%, from an estimated 5 million elephants to less than 500,000. This genocide not only severely reduces the genetic pool, it also wipes out entire cultures. Elephant cognition and culture are highly evolved. While humans can transfer and preserve their culture in writing, the entire culture of elephants is kept in their head and is transferred by oral communication. Killing an elephant, in particular adult males and matriarchs, as is often done, robs the entire remaining population of its culture and knowledge that are so vital for their survival. On this dark and depressing background shine several recent optimistic stories in elephant conservation. populations brought back from the brink of extinction by successful protection from poaching, as well as a renewed international ban on ivory trade. Enhanced international and local awareness, together with the unbelievable resilience of elephants, let us hope that humans will learn how to continue to share our planet with these wonderful beings. We sincerely hope that this video and course will play their modest role in promoting this vision.
In his famous book, The Little Prince, Saint-Exupéry said, "Beware of the baobab trees because they can blow up a little planet." Fortunately, our planet is much bigger and there's no danger that baobab trees will blow it up. Unfortunately, though, human beings might blow it up. And one of the aims of this course is to show you how lovely our planet is and that you should take care of it and not blow it up and not destroy it in any other way.